everyone. My name is A. Ritika Reddy, working as an assistant professor in Vignans Institute of Information and Technology. In today's session, you will be learning some more concepts of discrete mathematical structures of Unit 4. And the topic which you are going to learn is what are these inhomogeneous recurrence relations and how you can solve these inhomogeneous recurrence relations. Okay? So, a recurrence relation is called inhomogeneous or non-homogeneous recurrence relation if it is of this form. Homo means what? Homo means which belongs to a same category or same type. Non-homo means it is little bit different from the same one type of thing. So how do you need to solve such non-homogeneous or inhomogeneous recurrence relation? Suppose this is the format. See, if this Fn is not there, then this is the homogeneous recurrence relation. And to solve the homogeneous recurrence relation, what are the methods? Either you can substitute the values or you can find the previous term, future terms from the previous terms, or you can solve them using the characteristics roots method. Okay, that is if Fn is not there. But what if this Fn is there, which is making differentiation between the homogeneous and non-homogeneous? If Fn is there, then the method of solving will be different. First, suppose what will the initial step is that we will be assuming that it has two solutions, and the first part of the solution is nothing but AH of the associated homogeneous recurrence relation. That means whatever in the previous example we have obtained 3 power m, in the previous session you have obtained the example, right, of characteristic roots. That is the whatever solution over there it is obtained, that we are assuming it as AH. So if you ignore this one, then if you try to solve this equation using our regular methods, then whatever solution you are obtaining, then that solution we are assuming to be AH. And the second part is nothing but, that means here now you need to ignore this one. If you ignore this one, then this is the second part, and whatever solution which you are obtaining from this Fn, the second part is called as the particular solution and it is denoted by At. So the combination of this Ah and At will be giving you the solution of the inhomogeneous recurrence relation, which is nothing but An. Okay, now we will be seeing how you need to solve this At, because from the previous method you have learned how you can solve Ah, but you will be seeing how to solve this At and how you can combine them. Okay, so the first part, as I already said, you can try from the earlier methods, and to find the particular solution, which is nothing but the second part, we find an appropriate trial solution. So how you can find this trial solution? First, suppose we are supposing this Fn is equal to Cx to the power of n. In the maximum of the examples, you will be getting the problems of this type only. So you will need to solve how to find the solution of this particular Fn. Let Fn is equal to Cx to the power of n, and I have taken x square is equal to Ax plus b is the characteristic equation of the associated homogeneous recurrence relation. As I already said, whatever homogeneous recurrence relation is given for you, you can assume that to be in the form of characteristic equation, and from that characteristic equation you can find the roots, and from the roots you can get back the solution of the recurrence relation. So here this one I am assuming to be the characteristic equation of the given homogeneous recurrence relation, where x1 and x2 be the roots. Now the first condition for the solution of this Fn will be if x is not equal to x1 and x is not equal to x2, then the particular solution will be A into x to the power of n. That means what is this x? This value. We will be finding this value of x through our problem, na? So whatever x value you will be obtained, if that x value is not equal to either of the roots, that is, it is not equal to x1 and it is not equal to x2, then the solution of the particular, so that second part will be A into x to the power of n. For suppose, if x is equal to x1 and x not equal to x2, that means it can also be like x is equal to x2 and not equal to x1. That means that x value should be equal to one of the solution of the that x1 and x2 roots. Then in that case, the particular solution will be a n into x to the power of n. Okay. Next, if x is equal to x1 is equal to x2, that means the value of x will be equal to both roots. That means x1 and x2 you will be getting same value. That in the case of single root you will be getting na. If that single root is equal to this value of x, then you will be getting a t is equal to a n square x to the power of n. So these are the particular solutions which are obtained depending upon the values of this x, x1 and x2. Now we will be seeing a problem through which you will be clearly learning how. Okay, now you will be seeing one problem related to inhomogeneous recurrence relation. In the previous session I have said you what is inhomogeneous recurrence relation. A recurrence relation which consists of a homogeneous solution and a particular solution is called as an inhomogeneous recurrence relation, and this is the problem which is related to inhomogeneous recurrence relation. I'll give a brief overview. For an inhomogeneous recurrence relation, you will be having the recurrence relation of this type, like fn is equal to fn minus 1 plus b into fn minus 2 plus f of n. If this f of n is not there, then this one is a homogeneous recurrence relation. As this f of n is present, for this we need to find a solution separately. So the combination of this one and this one will be giving you inhomogeneous recurrence relation. Okay, so now the problem is, I have given a recurrence relation fn is equal to 3fn minus 1 plus 10fn minus 2 plus 7.5 to the power of n. And I have given an initial conditions f0 is equal to 4 and f1 equal to 3. Now we will go step by step. First we will try to solve, find the homogeneous solution, and after getting the homogeneous solution we will find the particular solution, and later we will club both and we will find the overall recurrence relation solution. Okay, so I will take the homogeneous values. Like if I am taking fn is equal to 3fn minus 1 plus 10fn minus 2. Okay, now I need to write this in the form of characteristic equation. As you have already learned, I will be writing directly. So this fn can be represented as x square is equal to 3x, this is minus 1, plus 10. I am not writing any power over here, it is x power 0. Okay, so now I will find the roots of this equation. So how I will be finding x square minus 3x minus 10 is equal to 0. That implies what are the roots factors of this particular equation, x square minus now 10. So 2 into 5 will be giving you 10, and 5 minus 2 will be giving you 3. 2 minus 5 will be giving you minus 3. So what I will be writing over here, x square minus 5x plus 2 minus 10 is equal to 0. So I will be taking x common from these two. I will be writing it as x into x minus 5 plus 2 into x minus 5. Because 10 is equal to 2 into 5, as I have taken 2 as the common, I am writing x minus 5 is equal to 0. So that will be giving you x minus 5 into x plus 2 is equal to 0. So what will be my final roots? X is equal to either it can be 5 or it can be minus 2. I will be considering this 5 as x1 and this minus 2 as x2. Okay, now I got the roots. Well and good. Now what is the next procedure? The next procedure is how we can find the homogeneous solution using the characteristic root method. That also we have discussed. So directly I will be writing, as I have got different roots, 5 and minus 2 are different roots, right? So what will be the solution having two different roots? It will be a h is equal to a into x1 to the power of n plus b into x2 to the power of n.
this is the solution of the homogeneous recurrence relation. So now what I will be doing, I will be substituting this 5 and minus 2 in this place. So what I will be getting, AH is equal to A into 5 to the power of n plus B into minus 2 to the power of n. Okay, till here we have got. Now what I will be doing, I will be substituting this, I will be adding these two. This AH I have got. Now look into this Fn. What is this Fn? 7.5 to the power n. So this is one part. Okay. One second, guys. This is one part. What about the remaining part? I am taking Fn is equal to 7.5 to the power of n. And from the inhomogeneous recurrence relations definition, I have said how to solve this Fn. See, if you observe this, this is of the form C into x to the power of n. And from the steps of the solution, if the relation is of this form, then you need to compare the value of x from with the roots of the homogeneous equation. Now what is the value of x? In this case, the value of x is 5. So just compare whether any of the roots are being equated with this one. Is 5 equal to x1? Yes, 5 is equal to x1. That means x is equal to x1 and x is not equal to x2. As 5 is not equal to minus 2, I have written x is not equal to x2. So what will be the solution in this case? At will be equal to an into x the power of n. This is a standard formula which is derived, and you have seen about this formula in our session. Okay, so what will I need to find from this? I need to find the value of a, because n depends upon the number we have taken and x we already know. So what will be the solution? At will be equal to a into n into, what is the value of x over here? 5 to the power of n. So what, in order to find the entire inhomogeneous solution, we need to club this at with this ah. That means I will be writing an is equal to ah plus t, right? Then what is the value of ah? A into 5 to the power of n plus b into minus 2 to the power of n plus at. What is the value of at? An into 5 to the power of n. Okay. Okay, now, so this is an. Now, what are the unknown values in this problem? A is one unknown, n is one unknown, b is one unknown, a is one unknown. So, we need to find all these unknown values. We will sort one by one. So, now the value of n is there. Value of n depends upon the that particular variable. So, you can get the value of n. Now, I need to find a and b. But in order to find A and B, you need to get the value of A. So, how I need to find the value of A? As this is our given recurrence relation, and we got to know like An into x the power of n is one of the solution of this recurrence relation, then we can represent this recurrence relation in this form. As this is also one of the solution of that particular recurrence relation, I can substitute Fn in the place of an into x power n. So how I will be replacing, you will be seeing. Now this is the second part. This is the first part of the solution. This is the second part of the solution, and you will be seeing the third part of the solution. Sir, can I write this side visible? Okay. Now I'll be writing over here. So how I'll be writing Fn? I'll be writing an into x the power of n is equal to 3 into, now what is there, fn n minus 1. That means in the place of n, I am writing n minus 1. So that itself I need to replace over here. So it will be considered like a into n minus 1 into x the power of n minus 1. Okay. Now what's the next variable? It is 10 into fn minus 2. So how this fn minus 2 will be written? 10 into a into n minus 1 n minus 2 into x the power of n minus 2 plus 7.5 to the power of n. That will be written as it is. Okay, this is the overview of the part we have got. Okay, now from here how I need to resolve? Just check whether any known values you know. Yes, I know the value of x. I know. So what I'll do, I'll be substituting value of x, which is 5. So 5. So in the place of x, I'm writing 5. Okay, now I replaced x. So next, now what I need to do? I need to resolve the value. What are the unknown variables in this equation? One is n and one is a. We need to find the value of a. So now we will try to reduce the value of n so that the n will be demolished from here and only a is left. So the first method is I don't need this n over here. So I will try to solve this by using the divide rule. I will try to divide by 5n minus 2. I will be dividing both left hand side and right hand side by 5 to the power of n minus 2. So what I'll be getting, if I divide this an, okay, so what is the next step? I need to divide by 5 to the power of n minus 2 in order to resolve this n, and we will be left over only with a. So what if I'll divide with 5 to the power of n minus 2? What if 5n is 5 to the power of n is divided by 5 to the power of n minus 2? 5 power n, n will be get cancelled, and I will be left over with, see this side, an into 5 square. Because 5 power n gets cancelled, I will be remaining with 5 square that I have written over here. And what is the next one also? I need to divide with 5 to the power of n minus 2. If 5 power n minus 1 is divided by 5 power n minus 2, I will be left over only with 5. So I will be writing it as a into n minus 1 into 5. Okay, and the next one is 10 into a into n minus 2 into 5 power n minus 2. So 5 power n minus 2 I am dividing with 5 power n minus 2. Both will get cancelled. I will be left over only with 10a into n minus 2. So that's it, right? And plus 7 into 5 power n. 5 power n divided by 5 power n minus 2. 5 square will be left over. So I will be written as 7 into 5 square. Okay. Now I need to solve this entire equation in order to get the value of a, as n is still visible over here. So what will be the RHS side? RHS side will be redefined to 5an minus, here one more 3 is there. Okay. So 5 into 3 will be 15, right? So 15an it will be written. Next, 15 will be multiplied again with 1. Again with a and with 1. So it will be 15a only. Next, what is the second one? Second one will be 10an plus 10an and 10 into 2. So it will be 20a plus 7 into 5 square. Keep it as it is for simple division purpose. So what I'll be getting? 5 square means 25. So 25an. So just subtract, get the similar kinds one side and other side. So 25an minus 15an plus 10an. So 25an here, 25an here. So this 25an will be cancelled with this, because 15 plus 10 will be equal to 25. These both will be cancelled. So now all the n's are vanished. So now with what I am left over? I am left over with 15a and 20a. Bring these both to the left hand side and try to add. So what I'll be getting? 35a, which will be equal to 7 into 5 square. So I'll be dividing 7 with 35 5 times and 5 with 5. one time, so I'll be left over with A is equal to 5. Okay, now we got the value of A. So what I'll be doing now, I'll be substituting this value of A in this equation. I will rub away all these things. Freshly I'll be substituting. Sir, pause the answer. Okay, now we got the value of A. Now, okay, keep it aside. Now I'll try to elaborate this equation. So now the value of N is there. From this equation, how to find the value of N? We don't know the entire value of N for the entire range, but we know the value of N and the solution of that N over from this equation. Here I am given the initial condition, like the first term, which is F naught, will be equal to 4, and the second term, which is F1, will be equal to 3. So in this case, N value will be 0, and this case N value will be 1. So we have some solution, like when N equal to 0, 4 will be the solution, and when N equal to 1, 3 will be solution. That similar thing we'll try to impose over here, and after imposing we'll further reduce this equation, and then later we'll substitute this value of A and you will be getting the entire solution. So now first, F naught or A naught doesn't matter, it all means the initial term itself. So now A naught, which is nothing but is equal to F naught, is equal to 4, is equal to, now that 0 I'll be substituting in the place of N. So it will be like A into 5 to the power of 0 plus B into minus 2 to the power of 0 plus A N 5 to the power of 0, and this N value is nothing but 0 only, na? So this entire term will be 0. So it will be rewritten as, no, 5 power 0 means 1, so it will be A as it is plus B into minus 2 power 0 means 1, so B as it is, which will be equal to 4. Okay, this is one equation which we derived. Now, and the other term which we have is F1. In the case of F1, N value will be equal to 1. So A1 is nothing but F1, which is nothing but the second term, will be equal to 3, and N, if I replace with 1, it will be like A into 5 to the power of 1 plus B into minus 2 to the power of 1 plus, what is the value of A? 5 into 1 into 5 to the power of 1. So if I solve this, I'll be getting 5 power 1 means 5 only, na? So 5A minus 2B plus 25, 5 into 5, 25, will be equal to 3. That means 5A minus 2B will be equal to 22. So two equations are there, two unknown variables are there. So we can solve these both and we can get the equation. So in order to solve this, here minus 2b is there, here b is there. So what will I be doing? I'll be multiplying both left hand side and right hand side with 2. So what I'll be getting? 2a plus 2b is equal to 8. Okay, this equation now I'll be considering. So here I'll be writing 2a plus 2b is equal to 8. Now I will be adding these both. So if I add these both, here negative is there, here positive is there. So how it will be, these both will be cancelled, and this will be turned to 7a is equal to, here here actually minus 22, not 22, because 25 will be gone to here, right side, so minus 22 will be there. So minus 22 and plus 8, what I'll be getting? I'll be getting minus 14. So 7 will be cancelled with minus 14, minus 2 times. So A will be equal to minus 2. Okay, so now we got the value of A. What will I be doing? I will be substituting this minus 2 in this one, in this one. So I'll be getting, don't get confused, from here directly we have moved to this step. Okay, so minus 2 plus B is equal to 4. So what I'll be getting? B is equal to 6. So now I got A value, B value, capital A value, and everything we got are unknown terms. So now I'll be substituting over here and I will be getting the final solution. The final solution will be AN is equal to, what's the value of A? Minus 2 into 5 to the power of N plus what's the value of b? 6. 6 into minus 2 to the power of n plus what's the value of capital A? 5. 5 into n into 5 to the power of n, which is nothing but here you can also write as 5 to the power of n plus 1. Okay, so this is the final solution of the inhomogeneous recurrence relation, which is represented over here. So in the question part, what I am given, I have written the inhomogeneous recurrence relation in terms of itself, in terms of its previous terms. So we have solved one by one and have written most of the part in the numerical part itself. So what is the first step? First step, I divided into homogeneous, and second was the particular solution. First, then I calculated the homogeneous solution using the method of characteristic roots, and I have derived two roots. After getting the roots, two roots, I have represented the solution using the basic steps of the homogeneous solution. Later, I have moved the particular solution, and then I compared that homogeneous roots with particular solution root. And as one solution, one root is equal to that value of x, I have written whatever c into x power an into x power n. Then I have clubbed both. After clubbing both, I got to know some unknown variables. And first I tried to solve the value of a from those unknown variables by substituting that an, that whatever solution of that particular solution in the given recurrence relation, and I derived the value of a. Later I substituted this value of a in the two equations which I have got, and after substituting I have got the values of a and b. So from in this session you have known how to solve a inhomogeneous recurrence relation. You have known what is an inhomogeneous recurrence relation first. Then you have learned the steps of solving inhomogeneous recurrence relation. You have worked out on an example regarding that one. Okay, thank you.